Taskade. Which one do you want? I don't know. That's why I'm making the video. TickTick is a very basic task management app, and Taskade is more of a task and project management app put together. And I wanted to make this comparison because a lot of these two are pretty popular in the market and actually have a decently similar functionality from a task perspective. They just have different views, different plans, and it's important that I break down those things for people sometimes. First of all, TickTick is the cheaper option. If you want to get the pro version, you can get it for $2.4 a month, and it allows you the same-ish amount of integration. So I'm just going to cut that whole integration part out of the video. Very similar. You kind of have a sync with both of them on the premium plan. That's kind of all that really matters. And on the unlimited version, so the same premium version for Taskade, $5 a month. Now you're going to have unlimited tasks in both of these different options for free. And I do like that. And I do appreciate the fact that both of these from a free standpoint are pretty solid. I'd say that the mobile app for TickTick is exceptional as well as Taskade. So those are pretty much a wash in my opinion from that perspective. And for a lot of people, people end up going with TickTick because it's cheaper than like ToDoIst for premium, or even it just like looks better to their aesthetic for free. I personally think that Taskade is the better option if at all you're going to be using this for teams. So when going into the system, what you're going to see is a lot of really nice views from a board perspective, list, calendar, actions page, this mind map, this organizational view. All of these different structural components are things that make teamwork and collaboration better, whereas TickTick may be a little bit better for your personal use. Something that TickTick has on Taskade is the fact that it has an Eisenhower matrix and it has habit tracking, whereas you do not even get a calendar view for free on TickTick, which is a bit annoying. Not gonna lie, I don't like the fact that ToDoIst doesn't have a calendar view. I don't like that TickTick needs it for premium, and I don't really like that because it's just another way to visualize date properties, and that's just like, why would you paywall that? But for me, I do understand as a business that they have to structure things in a sort of way that they're profitable, and if that's what they got to do, that's what they got to do. And it is a really cheap option, so I'll give them that. Something to note about this platform is that they're going to have a bit of natural language processing. So I do getting things done, then do an at tag, and I typed today in and it did it. So if every week gets put in there, you'll see that it has a recurring option. Do this task for at work, and when you put a pound sign, it ends up bringing this into place. So that can be done for hashtag housekeeping, clean your room, and then that'll go there. You can sort things in different lists and via tags, which is really nice in TickTick. And the main views that you're going to get out of this, if you go here, is just the Kanban board view, and then go back here is just going to be the list view. You do have the option to show task time or not right here. And there are just a couple different things that can tweak the way that you can look at these. I also do really like the fact that in TickTick, you have the ability to look at things and have a Pomodoro timer. So over here, if you go into settings, you can see that there are a bunch of different ones here. So there's a focus timer. And if you press Control Alt P, it allows you to bring this up on your screen. And this is just a nice little aesthetic and functional thing that you can do within this application, whether it be on your phone or on your desktop, in order to focus and have different intervals and figure out how long you're doing these Pomodoro timer sessions. Whereas Taskade doesn't really have those kind of like personal tip and trick functionalities in them. You're going to be able to do really nice things from a team management perspective, because as you'll see here, you can call or do a chat or add files within Taskade. And if that's something that's more towards your needs, definitely go with that, because the recurring functionality, very similar. The tag functionality, decently similar. However, you're gonna get a few more views in Taskade, like calendar that might matter to you, or mind map, or organization that might matter to you, or even just a table instead of a list. Some people really care about that. And you're gonna have actual projects. The difference between these two platforms is that TickTick only really has lists, and Taskade has projects as like the overarching thing with tags within them. Having multiple team members on Taskade for free is a really big perk that a lot of other applications don't have, as it is an unlimited amount of people you can add to it. And TickTick is pretty much personal. So if you're not really looking for a personal solution and you're looking for something to add different people into, I would recommend trying out Taskade before you try out TickTick. Although I do gotta say, for personal use, I would recommend ToDoIst or TickTick to anybody right off the jump if they're getting into their personal productivity journey, as it is simple, easy, and quick to add tasks on your phone, on the computer, and to stay focused with Pomodoro timers. If you want to stay focused on how to improve your productivity, though, you check the... What? Watch that.